Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial video. Today we are going to be talking about how to live stream on YouTube from start to finish. So if you don't know how to stream at all on YouTube, this is the video tutorial for you. I will put timestamps in the description so you can hop around to the specific part that maybe, you know, you're bottlenecking or you're having a problem with, but I would recommend watching the entire video. That way, you know, from start to finish, how you can set up your live stream. All right, couple of things here. First, there are requirements to be able to live stream on YouTube. They are much less than what they used to be, but we're going to hop on over to the requirements now, and I'm going to show you what those are. All right, so if you are streaming on mobile, so if you're wanting to stream from your phone, you need to have at least 1,000 subscribers or more. Now, that restriction no longer applies to people who are streaming from their computer using a webcam like what we're going to be talking about today. So if you just want to open up the YouTube app on your mobile device and stream, you have to have 1,000 subscribers or more. Also, you need to look at the community guidelines. Do you have any strikes on your account? It needs to be in good standing. Also, if your channel is made for kids, and again, that may apply to some folks watching this video, please read this right here where it says made for kids restrictions. Make sure you read all of this before we jump into live streaming. Now, when it comes to live streaming, you're going to be needing software. Now, you can stream directly from YouTube and they provide you the tools to do so to connect up your webcam. I recommend you use a third-party software. Now, on my channel, I will link below, I have tutorials, full tutorials showing you how to use Streamlabs OBS, which is what you see right here in this video. This is the one that I use most of the time. I also use StreamYard. I've used Melon. I have used a bunch of other different tools, the native vanilla OBS software. I have videos showing you how to walk through all of those tutorials down below. If you look at this stream, if you look at this tutorial and you're like, man, I want to add all of those flashy transitions, alerts, things like that, I've got tutorials on all of that. I get all of my stuff from a website called nerdordie.com that it will also be linked down below. They are a partner of mine. If this video helped you out, get your stuff from there. It's a win-win situation. All right, so now that we know we have to have software like Streamlabs OBS, OBS, whatever it may be, that we link up to YouTube, let's jump into it. So go ahead and log into your YouTube channel. Once you're logged into your YouTube channel, go to your little studio here. So go to the YouTube studio. If you don't know how to get to the YouTube studio, click on your account icon there in the upper right-hand corner, and then go to YouTube studio. That'll take you to your dashboard immediately. And then once you're under your dashboard, what I want you to now understand is there's a couple of ways that we can begin a live stream. We can go live now. We can actually schedule a live stream, and I'm going to show you how to do both of those things right now. So the easiest way of doing it for me is to go up here in the upper right-hand corner and go to Create, where you normally upload your videos, and then go to Go Live. You can hit the Go Live button here or right here where the little Go Live icon is. So go there and go to Go Live. Once you do this, there's going to be a couple of options come available to you. This is the YouTube Live Control Room. Again, we can go live right now or we can go live at a later date. So if you want to schedule a live stream for a future date, maybe later today, maybe later this week, you would hit start right here under later date. And then once we do that, it'll then ask you, do you want to do it like what we just talked about? Do you want to use the built-in webcam, okay, or the webcam that you've got connected to your computer directly within YouTube? Everything's done within YouTube. Or do you want to use a streaming software? So if you want your stream to look the best that it possibly can, in my opinion, you're going to want to use a streaming software. So I'm going to go ahead and go through the streaming right now option. It'll be exactly the same than the scheduled stream, except for instead of setting a date for when this will go live and putting a thumbnail and all of that good stuff for scheduled streams, it'll just be going live right now. So hit start again, and then we're going to click go on the streaming software option here. Now, here we are on our YouTube Live Control Room. This is where we put all of the information that we need for our stream. The top line here is going to be the title of your stream. So put whatever you want the title of your stream to be here. Next, we're going to, whether you want the stream to be public, unlisted, so only folks with the link can view the stream, or private. If you're testing some stuff, maybe you would want that to be private. For the most part, I would say you probably are going to want to select public here. Next is going to be your description. Now, if you have something in your description as far as like that goes to every one of your videos, that will be shown here. If you don't have kind of like a already written out description that goes in all your videos that you kind of go from like a template, then this will be empty. You put your description here. Next, you'll have your category, and then you'll have your audience here where you need to say, hey, is this made for kids or is it not made for kids? And then under age restriction here, yes, restrict my video to viewers over 18, or no, don't restrict my video to viewers over 18. So again, all of that will be something that you will have to determine for your stream. Next, we will have a custom thumbnail. Yes, you will want to have thumbnails for your streams on YouTube. So what you would do is click the upload custom thumbnail button here. And then what you would do is you would just select whatever thumbnail that you've created for that live stream, double click or click open, and then your thumbnail will come up available to you here. Next will be the enable monetization option. If this is checked over to the right, that will enable monetization. If it's to the left, that means monetization is disabled. Again, depending on the type of content you're creating on your stream, you will need to decide what you want to do there. Once you've put all of the pertinent information here, click the blue save button. This is where all of the fun begins, right? Now, until we hit start stream on our streaming software, nothing will be live. So you can play around with all of this and understand all of the stuff that I'm about to talk about. So up here in the upper left-hand corner where you see connecting to streaming software, this is going to be the preview. So once we connect our streaming software, you can see what the stream will look like over here. Over on the right-hand side, it'll show you all the information that we just set up. It'll show you the viewers that are waiting for the stream if it's scheduled. It'll show you the amount of likes that you're getting for that stream as well. All right, so the most important thing now is getting your stream key to your stream software. So your stream key is here. I would leave this to default stream key unless your software tells you otherwise, and it probably will not. So go ahead and copy your stream key. So right here, you can either hit the copy button here. It'll copy to your clipboard, or you can just double click here, right click and copy if that's what you want to do. I don't even think it'll let you do that. I think you actually have to just copy it directly from the stream key option here. What you want to do now is go and hop back over to your streaming software. So for me, that's going to be Streamlabs OBS. And then what you'll want to do is go to settings. And then once under settings, you're going to want to find where the stream or output options are. And for each software, it may be a little different. And then once you're here, it'll have an option to insert your stream key. This is where you go and hit Command or Control V, paste in that stream key that we just got from YouTube. This is important, very important. If your stream key does not match up, if it's different, if you forgot to copy it, if you forgot to add it, it will never connect to YouTube and nothing will be sent from the streaming software over to YouTube. Extremely critical. Right here on my streaming software, it's got a drop-down menu here. I want to select YouTube. If Twitch is selected, change that over to YouTube. Some of the softwares will actually, once you insert the stream key, will detect that and change it to YouTube. Stream type, what we want to do is go to streaming services, leave that the same there. And then once you're good to go, you just click the green done button there. So now we have went ahead and attached our stream key. So the stream key from this stream on YouTube is now over on our streaming software. Never shared that with anyone, never show that to people publicly. That would allow them to stream from your channel, which is something that you obviously do not want to do. All right, once our stream key is here, you can then see where we have stream latency. I would go and leave this at low latency. This will depend on the internet connection speed that you have currently at your home or office or wherever you're streaming from. You know kind of what that would be. And then under our streaming software, we can change our bit rate. And we'll talk about that just in a second. All right, so now what we would do is we would hit the go live button over on our streaming software. So I hit go live here in the lower left-hand corner, okay? If you wanna walk along with me with Streamlabs OBS, I'll have a link down below where you can check that out. Now, if we hop back over to our YouTube stream here, you can see we are not, right now we are live on the channel. So as you can see right here, we're live right here on the channel. It tells us how long we've been live. And then it'll tell us a little bit of data about that as well. So now we can see our streaming preview up here in the upper left-hand corner once we've hit go live, okay? So that's what happens. When you want to end your stream, you hit the red button here that says end stream, and then go to end, and you will no longer be live. And it says congratulations, congratulating you on your live stream on YouTube. So Let's go back and talk about that once again. A couple of things that I want to talk about so you can optimize your stream to make it look the best that it possibly can look, okay? So now we're going to go hop back over to our streaming software, which is Streamlabs OBS. Now, what you see here, this is what you call a streaming scene. Again, in my Streamlabs OBS tutorial, I walk you through how to set up a scene. I walk you through how to switch them. As you can see, I can switch them on the fly. I have transitions right here. I have one for the desktop. Right here, I have another one that has me in the lower left-hand corner here. So again, all of these things that you're seeing, okay, so all the things that you're seeing here, these are called scenes within my software. So this is going to be what's pushing to YouTube from your third-party software, right? So once you've inserted your stream key, you hit go live, you're good to go. Now, remember, you probably would need to hit in stream on your streaming software as well. I forgot to kind of mention that to you guys as well. So a couple of things. You need to have a video source and an audio source. So for me, I have my microphone here, which is going into my streaming PC. So you need to have a USB microphone or an XLR microphone, whatever microphone that you have. I actually have an audio interface plugged in via USB to my PC. That's my audio. My video source could be a number of things. The video source for me is this camera that you see here. It's my Cam Link from Elgato. Again, you can use a Logitech webcam. It really doesn't matter. And then another video source, or what they call a browser source, would be like your desktop. So what you see here, when you're showing the game, this is a browser-based showing thing. So if you want to show your desktop or show a video game, that would be what they call a browser source. All of these things are different, whether you're using Streamlabs OBS, OBS, StreamYard, Melon, whatever you're using, they make title or call them something slightly different, but you need an audio and a video source to begin with, and then you're good to go. Now, as far as making it look good, adding alerts and things like that, again, I use nerdordie.com, but you can download free assets all over the internet to make your live stream look the way that you want it to look, okay? So a couple of things about quality of your live stream. When it comes to making sure that, are you getting a little bit of delay? Are you getting some lag? What you would want to do is go into settings under your streaming software, and then right here where it says output, what you would do is you would go here under streaming. Video bitrate for me is set to 2500. I could go much higher than that. Just for the tutorial, I set it fairly low. Normally when I stream, I start it at around 4500 to 6000 and go from there. Am I getting a little lag that day? I'll decrease that. Am I not? I kind of, you know, up that. Audio bitrate, I leave it 160. Encoder, I leave it 264. Normally the general default settings for all of these are fine, except for video bitrate. Again, that you want to play with. You know, if you're getting a little bit of a lag, you kind of go there. If you're getting a little bit of delay, let's say you're streaming and your voice doesn't match what's coming on the screen. There are ways that you can go into each software and adjust that. Within Streamlabs OBS, you can actually go into your microphone settings. So we can go here and we can go into, actually, I'm going to go into the overall audio settings altogether. And then what you can do here where it says sync offset, whatever microphone. So for me, it would be my right here, my Scarlett microphone USB. I would go here and I would go and I would change this number up or down until I made sure that my audio is synced up with my video. Again, most of the time it'll work just fine. Maybe it's bothering you. Maybe it's really badly off. You can adjust that here. Also under audio settings, while we are here, you always want to downmix your microphone to mono, because what'll happen when you do that, it will then, you know, whenever people are listening, it'll come out in stereo, but you want to downmix to mono into your software. And then when it goes out, it should be stereo if you have everything set up properly in your audio settings. So again, on the YouTube side of things, there's not that much that you really have to do other than when we're at our YouTube studio. So if we go here and we go back to our YouTube studio here, go to create, go to go live. That'll take us to our live streaming dashboard. Make sure you have your stream key here. Make sure that is pasted into your streaming software. And then once you've done that and added your thumbnail and all the data, you just hit go live on your streaming software and you're good to go. Now, if you wanted to use your webcam with YouTube, okay, if you just don't want to worry about a third-party software, all you would then do is basically right here where you see this little webcam option in the live streaming studio, you would just allow your webcam. So you would just allow your webcam, and then you just create a title, all that good stuff from there, and you are good to go. But I like to use streaming software because it looks better, and it's just, for me, it's just better. Now, once you go live over here on the right-hand side, you'll see the chat box right here on the right hand side. The chat box, you can hit these three dots over here and you can pop the chat out and drag that anywhere that you want to. So you can drag that chat anywhere you want to. And as folks come into your stream, they'll begin to chat here and you can respond to them verbally or with text right here. When I hit X, the chat box goes back to the right hand side over here, just like so. But I'm going to go ahead and go live once more from our streaming software. So I'm going to go ahead and go to go live. And then once I go live, I'm going to show you once more over here on the YouTube side of things. Now our analytics will pop up and it'll show us how many viewers, how many people are chatting, and it'll even tell you the connection status of your stream here. So again, as you can see, I'm up here in the left-hand side for me, and it shows me what I'm streaming, how long I have been streaming, and the stream analytics over here on the left. Now, a couple of new things that YouTube has allowed you to do is you can share this in the upper right-hand corner. You can add a stream marker, and you can even go here to create a highlight. Again, these are options that YouTube just recently released, and these are really cool features that you can do currently with that. And as you can see now, I have concurrent viewers. I have one viewer here, and then those viewers, if they are chatting, you would see that over on the right-hand side. Under stream health, excellent. Make sure your stream is healthy. If this is in the yellow or red, you may want to go back and adjust something on your end via your streaming software, and you should be good to go. Now, I'm going to end the stream by clicking end and then going end here and showing you really, really quickly. Now, obviously, once you've streamed, you could actually edit that stream VOD in your YouTube studio. If that's something that you want to do and post those as videos, they automatically go up to your videos if that's something that you want to do. But I actually want to show you a couple of things with the scheduling of the live stream. So if we go back to our YouTube studio, go to create, go to go live. Once we are here, what we will then do right here is, you see where it says manage? If we go to manage here, it says we have no upcoming streams. But once here under our YouTube live streaming studio, we can actually go to the blue button here that says schedule a stream. So if we click on schedule a stream, we'll go through all of the data insertion that we went through earlier, talking about title, description, thumbnail, that kind of thing. But right here is a new drop down where it says, when do you want to go live? So we'll say Saturday. We'll say what time? We'll say at 11:30 a.m. my time. And then once you've created that stream, what we then will be presented with is the live dashboard control room once again. But if we go back now to manage right here under manage, you can see now we have upcoming. We have this live stream with our thumbnail, with our title, all the information here. If you want to remove that or adjust anything about that, you can select this box, go to edit here, or we can go to more actions and we can delete that forever. So go here, we can delete that just like that. So that's everything you need to know about live streaming on YouTube. It's that simple. You just need to have an appropriate streaming software to make it look the best that it possibly can, a microphone, a webcam. You don't even really need a webcam, but you just need a computer and a microphone and you should be good to go. If you have any questions, please put those in the comment section below. Me or my community will get to those as soon as possible. Don't forget, if you're looking to use how to use some of these streaming softwares that I talked about today, those will be linked down below as well. And I will see you guys in the next video.